In fact, that African culture where the woman is told to vumilia. You know, mwanamke ni kuvumilia. How many times have you heard mwanamke ni kuvumilia? You are at home being a good wife, but your husband is out there anakuletea magonjwa, STDs, kinsonono, kaswende, gonori. Hey guys, welcome to my channel. Today is the 30th of May 2020. And it is our wedding anniversary. Yes, we got married on 30th May 2009. So this year should clock 11 years of marriage. Even if, and here's the tea, we are celebrating 10 years of marriage because we are separated for 1 year. Yes, I know this one will come as a surprise to so many people. And since I love to keep it real, in 2015, me and my husband, we went different ways. Some of my friends and family will be shocked to hear this story because I did not share with so many people. By the way, on Facebook, I was still slaying. On Instagram, I was like, ooh, happy life. And that's why I'm here to tell you, don't trust no social media controlled content. Yes, don't hate your life because on social media, you're seeing someone popping champagne. Maybe behind the scenes, they are not happy. In 2015, as a single parent in a foreign country, it was hard. But I was still taking photos that I look at today and I'm like, oh my God, if people knew what I was going through behind the scenes, they cannot believe. You want me to share my story of how I was separated and how I managed to survive as a single parent in a foreign country? Leave your comment down below. And I will share my story. Yes. Also, I wanted to say that marriage is not easy. To be able to survive 10 years, it has taken a lot of patience. It has taken a lot of maturity. It has taken a lot of understanding because, first of all, a marriage without understanding is not going to work. A marriage without good communication is not going to work. A marriage without respect is not going to work. And a marriage that is one-sided is not going to work. Like, if you are the one who is loving your spouse and is treating you like shit, is not going to work. I am here to say that marriage works, but you should not stay in a marriage if you're being mistreated. You should not stay in a marriage if your spouse does not respect you. You should not stay in the marriage because of them kids. I'm not telling you that now the first quarrel you pick your bags and go. But if you're being abused physically, psychologically, and I feel like sometimes psychological abuse is the worst. That is a pain or a wound that is not going to heal. And this one I'm going to speak to an African woman. Most of the time, our culture tends to tell the woman you need to persevere. Even if your husband is mistreating you, even if your husband is unfaithful, even if your husband does not provide, you need to vumilia. You will hear most of the time an African woman being told, mwanamke ni kuvumilia. So you can be beaten, you can be mistreated. You just stay there and they'll tell you, unaenda wapi na watoto? Where are you going with the kids? And this is one thing that makes me go crazy. By the way, African men, sometimes they feel like they can do whatever they want because even the government has not put in rules and regulations. Like here in Italy, if you separate, the government gets in and tells the husband, you need to take care of these children. But in Africa, a man can just give you 20 children, 25, and he will still leave you and go create another family over there. And we saw the other day that saga of the boys' club that Obare, Alifukua Makaburi, you know. And I'm very sure most of these women are not going to leave their men because the culture, the African culture say, mwanamke vumilia kapo upigwe. Mwanaume ende lale uko inje na wanawake wote. You just stay there and be a good wife. You are a faithful woman in the house. You are cooking for your husband. You are taking care of the home. You are taking care of the children. But the husband is out there giving mujuals to any hole. Because any hole is a goal for him. Anakuletea magonjwa, kisonono, kaswende, gonoria, HPV. And HPV is this virus that causes uterus cancer. Unakaa hapo unaletea magonjwa, you being a good wife, but the society will not allow you to leave that marriage because they're going to talk about you. Girl, pack your bags and go. Don't be afraid of what the society is going to say. Don't get me wrong, eh? I'm not telling you to leave your marriage, the first quarrel, you leave your marriage. But if you feel like you're not getting nothing out of that relationship, if you feel like you cry every day because your spouse is not treating you right, if you feel like you're in a toxic relationship, there's always light at the end of the tunnel. Don't stay there because of the children. Because most African women, they are like, nitaka hapa kwa sababu ya watoto. I'm staying here because of the children. That's why I always tell women, get a job. Get where you can get your income. Even if it's 1,000 bob, that is yours. How many women are in the graves right now that have left their children because their husband killed them or their wife killed their husband? If they could have walked away, their children right now could have had a mother or a father. I've seen so many family members staying in abusive marriages because when they go back home to their parents, them relatives are like, we're familiar. So yes, guys, that's what I had for today. And happy anniversary to us. If you liked this video, don't forget to share it. Don't forget to like it. Don't forget to comment. And all that good jazz. Thank you. Bye-bye.